KPIs and all those things are evaluated and the metrics are evaluated. Okay. But the SIM is also going to allow the suppliers to do registration again. That is weird, no? Because Nariban, for a Nariban network also, me as a supplier can register.
Yes. Yes.
And
I mean,
let's say you are a supplier, okay. So you would only want to do, you registered in Ariba network. Now one of your customer is implementing SIM. Would you also go and register again in SIM?
No, I mean there is some logic missing. I think you are saying supplier already registered on network. We have a business with him. We had a business with him. Is that right?
No, we don't have a business with him, but he is a sub. Okay, Microsoft is already registered in Ariba network, independent of whether he is my supplier or not. And me as a customer, for example, I am Sony. I am implementing Ariba sourcing as well as Ariba SIM. Okay.
Okay.
So if I implement Ariba sourcing and Ariba SIM, would Microsoft want to register again in SIM?
No, not required. It has to register to your application. I mean, register in the sense it need to be onboarded in your application. That's it.
Application meaning
your solution. SIM is your solution. You can see over here, right? This is your solution where I bought sourcing, procurement, suppliers and all. This is my solution. Now,
I can choose to register only in SIM, but I don't have to register in Ariba network, is it?
Sorry, come again?
Can I choose to register only in Ariba network? Can I choose to register in Ariba network only and choose not to register in SIM and still get the same benefits of collaborating with the...
You're just confusing, you know, the thing. There is nothing like that. See, I'll give you simple.
Sure,
the reason behind, so this is sourcing, right?
Hang on, this is sourcing, yes, correct, yes.
Sourcing. We created some events using sourcing projects and we invited some suppliers, right?
Correct, agreed, yes.
Where are these suppliers coming from?
These suppliers are in Ariba network.
Solution also. I mean, we have those in solution. I selected some suppliers, right? While inviting, I said to you, right? I have some suppliers in my system. I have some suppliers in Ariba network. I have some suppliers who I don't know. I just know their name and contact details. So I'm sending invitation to them. That is third process.
Okay.
So first and second are some suppliers on network, some suppliers are on my system. I showed you, I searched with Dinu Construction, which is already in my system. I showed you Channa Transportation.
I just want to understand this a bit more. When you say your system, do you mean your local ECC, SAP ECC?
It might be local SAP ECC or it might be Ariba solution. See, Ariba solution and Ariba network are both a different platform. They are just connected to each other. Right, they are integrated, but both are different platforms.
So that means in the Ariba sourcing, I will be still able to use the suppliers who are created in SIM or who are created in Ariba network, or both, or they could have been replicated from ECC to SAP Ariba.
Yes. So you just SIM is nothing. SIM is a module which will help you to, you know, The supplier was what already exists in your application, Ariba solution. You just manage those supply with the help of SIM module. If you want to onboard, see, I don't have any sourcing request to create or sourcing event to create, but I want some suppliers to be onboarded into my system, because at the time of creating event, I don't want to, you know, do in hurry worry, or I just wanted to go in easy flow. So when I get time, I want to onboard some suppliers into my system. So using SIM, you can do that onboarding.
Okay. So far. So far it's clear. So far it's clear. Also, please explain me. So, I am a new potential supplier. I'm a potential supplier for your company. Okay. So
okay.
Let's say you belong to the Ferrari group of companies. I am a potential supplier. So I am not there in your ECC. I am not there in your Ariba. I am not there in Ariba network also. Okay.
Okay.
Now, for some reason, you know, you have published in your portal that any suppliers who are interested in doing business with me can come and register in this link. That link is the SIPM link. Is that correct?
That link is, if you are talking about come and registered in that link, that is a link which is related to Ariba network.
No, that's but not, why would you want me to register in Ariba network? Because you are interested in only having me as your supplier. Why would you want me to go and register in Ariba network? Because you see, you already have SIM with you, and using SIM, I still can register. If I register, you will be able to send me the RFX responses, the RFX questionnaires, and I will be able to respond to it.
No, from this solution we cannot, because every transaction passes through the network.
Okay.
See here,
I got it.
When I'm creating sourcing project also, it is going through the network. See, we have this solution, right? I mean, we have solution, but supplier has to log into the network. I mean, we cannot send, see, as you're saying, I have suppliers, I want to do business with them, I want to send using SIM. But how they will log in to that system? I mean, how they will get to know that you are sending through Ariba? They must be having some system, right? So that system is Ariba network.
Okay, that means I go and log in into Ariba network. Then where is the SIM coming into picture?
Log in into Ariba network. The link which he's getting is Ariba network link, and he has to just give some few details, and he has to just register over there. So that's free of cost for them, supply.
Fine, I registered now. Okay, so how am I coming inside the SIM system now? I mean, so far I'm like a normal supplier who just exists in Ariba network. So what is the difference between me dealing with a customer who has SIM and who don't have SIM?
See, just a moment.
Sure.
Hi, Karthik. Good morning. Yeah, so, Kasi, what happens when you send, SIM, when SIM comes into picture, I'll tell you, simple.
Sure. Okay.
SIM is to, you know, manage your existing supplier who are already there in your system. So it's not something like we have to go and register in SIM system. It's nothing separate system. It's a module. It's a tool helps you manage your own suppliers who are already present in your system. So that is basic thing. First thing, make note of it. Next. I'll take your example and try to explain you. I have one potential supplier. I'm sending request to him. consulting request to him using Ariba solution, right? So when I send him request, he'll be getting a link. So when I send him request, I have to fill few details. Few details. Can you please excuse me? I'm waiting. I'm sorry. Just.
Hello, KP.
Hi, Karthik. Good morning.
Very good morning. When you did start the session, it was like.
No, we still have not started it. As usual, I brought some general question about Ariba network. Maybe when he comes back, I quickly tell you what is my question. Maybe I don't know how good or relevant is this question for everybody. Okay, my question was, if a new supplier is to register to a company, will he register in Ariba network, or will he choose to register in Ariba network and supplier information management system if the customer has SIM? Because I understand SIM is a local module that is implemented by the customer themselves. However, Ariba network is something very open where all like you and me can go and register there. So let's say if you are already an Ariba network customer, Ariba network user as a supplier, and if your customer has SIPM, do you have to register again? Or if you don't have to register again, that means all information in Ariba network must go into SIM automatically, right? If it has to automatically go in, then what is the purpose of having SIM? And it's the same information. That's my question.
Okay, so I am back. Hi, Karthik. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Doctor.
So let me answer you, Kasi. So as you said, I have a potential supplier. I am sending invitation. So while sending invitation, I'll be picking up some few details, right?
Yes, correct.
So it will be registered in your solution as a supplier. Once he registered onto the network, so he'll be registered as your supplier. Now it will automatically goes to supplier information management or supply SIM. So the data will be automatically flowing into SIM. I'll try to show you this all thing into reality. I'll do one thing. I'll give your mail address as a supplier, some demo mail address as your supplier.
Fine.
So I'll create from my end. So this is one solution. So I'll create one supplier. Performance. Just a moment. So I'll create. You will get one link, right?
Okay.
You'll register back, and when I accept here, so you will be onboarded into my system, like the new construction or Channa Transportation. You saw, right? In the same way,
your system meaning I am only into the Ariba instance of this particular company. Let's call it Global Online Training. Okay.
Exactly. At the same time, the supplier is registered on Ariba network as well. So he'll be having the network access as well. So when he registers, when he opens the link and gives his detail, mandatory details there, when he's filling out and registering, he'll be getting ID and password. So that is his ID and password for network, supplier network.
Fine, I got it. So now I am available as a local supplier in the Ariba system, and at the same time I am also registered to the Ariba network itself.
Exactly.
Okay. So now where is SIM coming in picture?
So SIM is, see, as you said, I am registered in your local machine, local system, Ariba solution, right?
Correct. Correct.
And I am registered in network also. So this, all the suppliers who are registered in your system, Ariba system, in Ariba solution,
local.
Or all the suppliers who are in solution, all those can be managed using SIM module. So this is a module which helps you manage the your local suppliers in solution suppliers. So this is just a module.
Okay.
This is not, you know, something different system or something like that.
Okay.
It's a module which helps you in, you know, you manage your supplier or score or grade your supplier. That's it.
Okay, I understood this now. I think this, just for clarity's sake, no, Karthik, if you don't mind, can I ask one more question or should we go into the classes?
Yeah.
So just quote.
No, you can go ahead. You can. I don't know.
Yeah. In the event, if a customer is not having supplier information management in his licenses, will he not able to invite a supplier who is currently not registered in Ariba network?
No, nothing like that. Nothing like that. So,
so he can
I'll
still
give,
invite. He can still
yeah,
invite.
He can still invite.
Yeah,
he can still invite. Yeah, he can still invite, and the supplier. See, SIM is a accessory tool. You can have a car. You can ride it without sound system as well. Sound system is not mandatory, but to have a sound system, it feels good. So, you know, in the country, I mean, in the region, the APAC region or this Saudi and all. So there, the supplier information management are preferred very much because they have huge supplier base and they want to manage their suppliers by rating or, you know, scoring and grading by performance of the previous performance. So in that case, they just go with, you know, supplier performance management, where they can, you know, rate their suppliers according to their previous, you know, transactions. They can rate their suppliers. They can manage their suppliers. I mean, who are all my, you know, incumbent suppliers or best rated suppliers. So in this way, they just manage their supply. So it's not mandatory to have SIM to do transaction, any transaction. It's just necessary to manage your suppliers. So managing in the sense, just scoring and grading, rating them, or having a good relationship with them.
Okay, that means if I don't have SIPM, I will still be able to have them as my supplier by invitation. However, they will be only part of Ariba network, and
yes,
I will not be able to manage their scores and performance. I will not be able to do it.
Yes.
But in case if I have a SIPM, if I have SIM with me,
yes,
then I will be able to manage it. But however, there is a seamless flow between SIM and Ariba network, the seamless flow of data, meaning if he goes and updates the address in Ariba network, it also updates in SIM.
Sorry, last one, last point I didn't get you. If anybody
last
update,
point is, yeah. So you are a customer with SIM locally here,
yes,
with you.
Okay.
So I am your new customer, a new supplier. You send me a link which allows me to register one time, which makes me active both in SIM system as well as in Ariba network.
Yes.
Yeah. So now, at a given point in time, if I decide to change, for example, if I decide to change my account for payable clerk name, I will have to change in either one of the systems, either in Ariba network or in SIM. I don't have to change in both the places.
Actually, I mean, I read it somewhere, but I'm getting further. So actually what happens in supplier SI network, supplier has to update profile. That is I know, but I'm not sure whether it will reflect or not. I think it will reflect. I'll make note of it.
Yeah, okay.
Because
okay.
I it's somewhere.
Okay, okay, got it. So that is fine. That's fine. That's all. Okay. Thank you so much.
So you got a clarity.
I got a clarity. Yeah. Information update. Let me also take note of this information updated in SIM. Will automatically flow into Ariba network. Okay, that would also mean that I can have my own approval for suppliers other than Ariba network validating them, right? If I have SIPM.
Yes. Yes.
But if I don't have SIPM, I cannot approve the suppliers on my own. If he's an Ariba network supplier, I just can use it, that's all.
Sorry, come again, last point.
If I do not have a SIPM, that would only mean that all the whole worlds of suppliers can be utilized without any, can be just, I can just start using them. However,
yes,
there is
yes.
no control over to say whether they have any country specific or a category specific certification type of things I cannot capture because they're already a supplier.
Yeah, if you want, you can ask them while, you know, creating event, you can ask them questions, like we have questions, right? You can ask some question and you can specify that answer should be with attachment, like certificates.
But
or
that becomes a havoc, no? Because, you see, usually a tender process happens for 6 months, and sometimes it happens like, I don't know, 4 months or 6 months, or it could be longer also. So, I mean, now if we add more things like validating some common items also during the course of evolution of tender, that means tender duration will become even longer. For example, if I ask you, let's say, Indian nationality is a requirement to do business with me. Let's say that, okay? And this is something standard that needs to apply across all the tenders. Doesn't matter who works, doesn't matter who is going to be supplier. This is a mandatory item. The same way, I may have another condition to say, this supplier need to be an equal opportunity employer who gives equal opportunity for women, handicapped, and also men. Okay.
Yes, yes.
These questions are common across all the vendors, but if I start questioning that for every tender, the same vendor, same supplier will have to answer many times.
That is the best requirement for SIM, actually.
Ah, okay, got it. Now I thought I'm
understanding. Yeah. So SIM is not a different module. It's a part of Ariba solution where it will just manage your suppliers, or you know, filter out your suppliers, categorize your suppliers, as you said, regarding your, I mean, with respect to your requirement. So the supplier, all the suppliers will be, see, the supplier will be present in sourcing also, supplier will be present in procurement also. So supplier will be present all over the solution, any module. But this solution, this module help you out manage those suppliers. This module help you to, you know, raise a PO to that supplier. This module help you negotiate with the supplier on particular goods or services. So supplier will be there throughout the solution, just managing, every module has specific roles and, you know, responsibilities.
Okay, got it. Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, so thanks, Karthik, for your patience.
Thank you, Karthik.
So we'll go with template grinding. The other day we saw how sourcing project, and we create events, we create full project, we create multiple events. Excuse me, we can have documents assigned or we can have task assigned to some particular user role. So now for every event or every project, we should have a template in place using which we are creating the project. So yesterday you asked me, right, Kasi, regarding this group. I mean, well, we are creating a group inside a project, whether it will be applicable to each solution or it will be limited to the project. So as I said, it will be limited to the project itself. Those are called as project groups. So it will be limited to project. But if you want to create some specific groups outside the project, it will be applicable to all the projects. So it's like superset and subset.
If but you can specify at the time of create. But you can do this at the time of creating the group, is it?
Yeah, we can create. We can do this at the time of creating groups. So I mean, it's like you are creating in solution. So it will be applicable to all projects, whichever projects we are creating. If you are creating inside a project, it will be only limited to the project. Once the project is done, the group will be vanished. Or until and unless the project is going on, the group will be there. So that is the difference. So you got it, right? And next, SRM question regarding that, you know, extending of suppliers to different purchase organization. So that is clearly done in ECC. I mean, from Ariba solution, we cannot do anything. Even SAP Ariba also won't be able to do anything. It will send the suppliers to the system, to ECC system. Now, it's ECC guys work system responsibility to, you know, segregate or extend those suppliers to different purchase organization.
Yeah, but this again goes back. I mean, I think it's this one we got a better clarity, Karthik, right? Because in case if the customer has SIPM, then maybe he's able to capture additional information, which will help the approver decide. I don't know. Maybe as a part of supplier questions or something, he can just capture some information like which company code, and then the ECC guys can use this information to successfully extend them into different company code.
Yeah, if in that case we need to have some customized field, like as you're saying, company codes. So company code something related to ECC, and you want to map with this supplier. So some custom fields can be applicable. Yeah, we can do that as well. I mean,
if it is SIPM, we can create some custom fields, is it? Or
custom
solution
we can create in sourcing, in procurement, in supplier, SIM. Any solution, depending upon the license or depending upon the subscription, cost of subscription, they'll give some custom fields depending upon your requirement. You might need some few custom fields. So you have five or 10 custom fields, you just give your requirement. If it's possible, they'll get back to you. If not, they'll say it's not possible. It might affect the complete cloud solution. So that is what generally happens.
Okay. So the custom fields, I mean, they may license us to use the custom field, but the creation of the custom fields is still done by Ariba.
Yes. Requirement, we have to gather what is the requirement, but the creation or the customization of the fields will be done by Ariba.
Okay, got it, yeah.
So, okay, so that was your answer. So, I'll just quickly create one template and show what all are the things we can do with the template. So remember one thing, in any template, for suppose I created one template and I used that to some project, and after that, after using the template to any project, if I'm trying to edit the template, so template can be edited, but it won't be reflected to that project. It's already used. Now for coming projects, we can use that template, the version 2 template. And the version 1 template will be vanished. Only it will be applicable to the project which I already used. I'll show you the system, how it looks like. I'll show you. So that is one main thing we need to remember, because sometimes some customers ask, like, I made change to the template, but it's not reflecting to the project. The thing is, the template is already used. We created one project. Now it won't be applicable. I mean, the version 2 or the edited version won't be applicable to the project which is already created. It's taking so much time.
Okay, Rakesh, I mean, I was doing some research on this performance stuff, and I got to know that Ariba stopped committing on the response rate, individual response rate per application. Instead, they say on average, the response rate at the Ariba system will be a maximum of 2.8 seconds per transaction, or could be faster.
Oh, is it? I mean, I never know that.
Nah, I mean, I told you, yesterday I had a chance to meet some guys.
So you had a meeting with Ariba guys or someone?
No, it's not about Ariba guys, but the whole, I mean, generally, he's an account manager. So it just happened to meet him, but in general, for all the cloud solutions, SAP stopped giving a SLA based on the response time,
Okay.
I mean, they do give it, but their SLA says it is 2.8 seconds per transaction. That is also only for operations within Ariba. I mean, within the cloud solution, In our case,
even,
Ariba.
Even the system uptime, they claim that their system will be 99.9% up every time.
But I don't know, but
they even claim that as a SLA. I don't know how they are managing that much accuracy or that much high time. So this is how templates look like.
I know the measurement, because I did ask this question. I mean, I asked a lot of things from them. Maybe towards the end of the session, I'm looking for the document. That document, because I've taken some note. So in the document, they clearly mention how they measure it. They're using some company called Payment, some company. I don't know
Payment.
What is the company. Hang on. Let me just try to find out. This is.
Yeah, we can find it. So, I'll just go through this template. So this is how these templates, creation of templates looks like. Like, these are all the templates which already created it's a partner site where all the SAP implementation partners do their hands-on. So all these are the templates which already created in the system. And these are the folders we can, categorize, or we can merge those templates into one folder, and we can maintain it here as a quick link. Now, I just create a template. So it will ask for which type of template it is. As I said, every project or every event will have some or the other template. So these are the types of project or events we will have. Not only in sourcing, we can have in procurement, contract management, right? SIPM. So I am selecting sourcing project. The way you create template will be the same depending upon the rules and regulation of that module. So I'm selecting sourcing project and creating. So this is the first information you give. You selected template to create is sourcing project. I just gave higher level information. Now it's
can you do a small help for me? Can you please copy the name of it? Can you just copy the name and just show me the navigation again? Just copy it so we can come back and paste it. Don't have to spend time on that. You went to manage and you click on templates, but when you click on templates, there was a screen that was showing up, no?
Yeah, yeah. So you want to see the template in that page?
Yeah, because there is too many things, too many. I mean, maybe I don't know. Maybe I'm looking at it wrongly. If you cancel this now, you just cancel this, please.
Which one? This one?
Yeah, just cancel. Please help me cancel this one.
Yeah, so this is the page.
Oh, you went inside the documents.
Yeah, so I just selected create template from manage tab, manage create template, template tab. So it will be populated. So overview, just you know what are all those things there. So team will be like, you know, I mean generally here it will be organization team, enterprise. As this is a demo site, you can have so many templates and all, but generally in company, I mean in like any buyer, any client implemented the solution, they'll have limited templates and limited team. So template owner group will be there, or template creator group will be there. So all those team members will be available here. So now, as I said, every event, every project, every SIBM project or anything, every template will be counted as document in Ariba solution. That's a terminology. Everything will be counted as document. Even a PO, invoice, everything is a document in Ariba solution, right?
Okay, can you create now? Can you please? So you did an action and then you created a template.
So now we have to select sourcing project.
Nah, hang on, I think this is the one. So I have to choose the template for the right type of right type of transaction. Okay. Okay, got it. Exactly. Okay.
So Karthik, are we clear? Karthik.
Yes.
Sir, please interrupt me wherever required. Can you interrupt me? Okay. Okay. So I am taking some other name instead of this because this will be saved as a draft already. So the best thing of Ariba solution is, like for suppose you are working in any event or any document and suddenly you got stuck and you have to revert that, or you are closing, or your system got down, something, anything. By mistakely you just close like this. So it will be saved as a draft. Again, once you log into the system solution, you can easily work on that. So that is the best part of Ariba. It will be automatically saved as a draft. Can again open that and work on that. It's like same Gmail, composing mail, you got stuck, and again you can, it will be saved as a draft in your mail itself. That's what.
Okay, coming to the translation, and I see the translation is there almost in all the names and description, but I believe the translation can be only done for selected languages, I believe.
Yeah, I mean, language selected in the sense Ariba is having 60 different languages supported, 60 different 16.
Okay, great, great, great. Okay.
So all those languages will be applicable. I can show you. I'll show you the locale, how we change the locale. Locale in the sense language.
That's
fine. Okay. So full project. I'm thinking full project because the conditions, rules and tasks will be assigned to full project. So it will cover quick project as well. That's the reason I'm selecting full project template I'm creating. As soon as I click on OK,
it's very difficult to manage for SAP also, you know, the solution. Because you have too many moving parts in it for different customers. Right? One customer will have SIPM, one customer will have pen visibility. I don't know. So they have to enable it.
Yeah, the best part is Ariba can work on, you know, segregated modules. Like you can go with only sourcing, you can go with only SIPM. Like that, you can go with only spend visibility.
Okay, I understand that. I know you're logging in, but when we create a template, we can also attach the document templates to be used for certain type of activity. For example, there may be an document annexure. There may be a template for a particular annexure to get the vendor profile matrix, for example. That template can be attached as well, right? So then whoever is using that template, whoever is using that Ariba template to create the RFI or RFP will by default get those annexure template also, right?
Excel template.
Excel template, yeah. I'm just giving an example. It's common.
So you can download, when create a template, you can download the template form of that, I mean Excel, you can download the Excel. But you need not Excel format, you can just directly go into the template, you can download it into Excel. Is making me, you know. So I am targeting to, you know, complete this by 8th of March.
Okay.
So that is my target. So let's see how it carries out. I think, I mean, we can do it.
Yeah, I mean, 8th of March is the target for
completion of the
sourcing.
No, not sourcing.
Hmm.
Completion of the complete this Ariba training.
Wow, that's nice. Okay, but we have a lot of things now. We have contract management, procurement, but those are all easy.
No, actually, see, you just should know the system. I mean, again, going into the system, see, Ariba sourcing, this is the third or fourth day.
Maybe fourth day,
I think. Yeah, so fourth day.
Yeah.
We are almost done with sourcing. Now, contract management won't take those many days. It will take hardly one or two sessions because We just need to, you know, do contract compliance and all, contract authoring, I'll show you. So that doesn't take much time, because anyway, any application, the authoring of contract or creating contract will be depending upon the business requirement or company requirement.
Okay.
So contract management won't take much time. Now coming to procurement. Procurement will take as same as sourcing sessions. It will like 4 or 5 days. Then SIPM and spend visibility, we can complete both together. So SIPM also don't have much thing, much stuff like, you know, you'll have surveys and reporting, which is as similar as, you know, creating event. We can create event for SIPM, SIM events, and just need to send it to suppliers. They have to respond back. We have to review. We have to grade that according to the response. And we can maintain the data in our system. So that is about SIM.
Okay.
So these are the main solution. Now bundling those solution and all will be there. And we don't have a proper access to the network, buyer access to the network. So we cannot go in deep and have document automation and, you know, this type of solutions like APC, Ariba procurement content. So anyway, procurement will cover this APC catalog. So that's what my target is.
Rakesh, I was asking one day, like at the end of every, you know, solution, can we have common issues like for functional guys need? Like
common
functional
issues.
Support. Yeah, common issues with solution. Just.
You want like, as document or you want to discuss something about that?
No, just a 10 minute discussion, and we also need document. That would be helpful. Just 10 minutes, a brief.
We'll do that. So, issue in the sense, while implementing any project, if they are facing any problems, real time problems, something like that.
Yeah. Such kind of document, such kind of implementing and while supporting, AMS support kind of thing.
I'll do that. I'm sorry, I have to create. Again, because it's not created. So now it's created at the,
Actually, template, we have different templates, right? For RFI, different templates, and RFP, different auction, different templates.
Yes.
Right. So we are creating for which one now?
So the RFI, RFP are quick project, right? So when I say like I have two options, right? Like one full project, one quick project.
Yeah.
So I selected full project. So in that full project, I'll be having full project capabilities. Now, if you want to go with event or RFI, RFP, inside our template, you can create a sub template where you can specify whether it's a RFI, RFP or auction. I'll show you. Okay.
So then it becomes separate templates. If we want to use, we can use those also.
Outside the main template.
Yeah, if I want to create customize a template, if I'm creating a sourcing project and I want to use this customized template. So in this we are telling na sub templates RFI, RFP. So we can use this.
Yes. So these sub templates will be applicable to this main template only. If you are creating any, if you want to create a separate template or separate event template, you can have out of the main template. I mean, like I selected full project, right? If you are selecting quick project, from that quick project, you can create event templates like, you know, RFI, RFP.
Okay, what are templates we are creating? restricted to this template only. I mean this project.
Yeah, if we are creating, I created demo 18 as a full project template, right? If I am creating any template under this demo 18 template, it will be applicable to this template only.
Okay, got it.
Right.
Okay.
And if there is another option is also there, if you want to be, as you said, I want some sub template to be inserted inside this, demo 18 template. We have that option also for that. We have an option called document of choice, the template which is created outside can be inserted into this template, and the outside template anyhow will be accessed by all the templates or all the projects. But if you want to insert any specific template inside this template, you can do that as well.
Okay.
Don't get confused. You can do any ways you want. Right. Okay. So if you have any confusion, ask me. I'll definitely try to explain it one more time.
Okay.
No worries. So as we saw the full project, this template is looking like full project or not? Overview, document, task, team. Only these two are different. Again, history. As this is a template, we don't have message board here because we're not going to communicate with supplier using this. For that, we have a project in place. So in this overview, we give the brief of this template. What is this template about? Whether this template can be associated with the external system or not. So any doubts in this external system integration of the template, how template will be integrated to the external system? Any doubt like that?
Can you give me some real life examples that you have seen in the past for this external system integration for templates?
I was willing to show you this last few days.
Wow, this is an amazing flow.
I created this for my prospect client. So
okay,
this is to be process. They have some as is process. From that as is process, we created this to be process using Visio.
Hmm.
So this is what a typical functional consultant should do. A typical functional consultant. So yeah, they have PR, they have their system, PR is created, and from PR created RFQ, we have some release time. Karthik, can you put on, if you don't mind?
Yeah.
So yeah, they have ECC system, they are creating their PR, and it will go for release strategy. That is nothing but approval if any required for PR, because they have approval flow to certain amount. If the amount is up to 1 lakh, there is no need of approval. After that, they need approval flow for creation of PR. So once PR is created, we'll create a RFQ. Any doubts why we have to create RFQ, or can we go directly from PR to sourcing request? Any doubts in this?
Okay. I believe sourcing request can contain multiple RFQs. And RFQ does not have any release strategy, I believe.
No.
I don't know. I cannot remember that. But I know the answer,
yeah,
but I cannot remember.
Yeah, people. See, if sourcing is nothing but negotiating with you know, supplier. It's not creating PO. It's just negotiating, or we are just requesting for some information, some quotation or some proposal, right? So PR is something, you know, related to PO. We are creating purchase equation, and it will be converted to PO. So PO, PR cannot be directly, you know, go for quotation. So PR is purely related to purchase order. I know the product, I know what to buy, I am going with that line item and I'm directly buying. But RFQ is something where we don't know the rate of the commodity, or we don't know, you know though, right? When is the time we create RFQ? When we want some information from the supplier, when we want some commercial terms from the supplier, we create RFQ. So sourcing solution can only be integrated with RFQ. I'm sorry. Only be created with RFQ, not with PR. So RFQ will be integrated. Once RFQ created in SAP, it will be flown to Ariba system as a sourcing request. Now, sourcing request is also different from sourcing project. Here, it
sorry,
will come as
sourcing. I have a question. Sorry, Rakesh. Yeah. The RFQ to sourcing request creation is a out of box integration. Right? We don't have to do any customization.
No. We have to do that.
It's not an out of box integration. So there must be some
capability. While selling, we say that we have that capability, but we have to do that.
When we say we have to do it, that means you export it like an IDOC or something, do a mapping in PI or PO, and then call some web services to create.
Go ahead.
So, and then call some web services in, because I'm sure this is a very standard item, so Ariba might be giving some web services to create the sourcing.
Yes.
So, and you call that from the PI or PO, is it?
Yes. Perfectly all right. I mean, it will be integrated using PI, and you know, from SAP ECC we'll have IDOC, and from our and our Ariba solution we'll have CXML. So both will be integrated using PI. So that's what.
Rakesh, can we have PR from ECC to directly, you know, converting into PR in Ariba, so
Sorry?
That we can carry out sourcing? Can't we have PR can directly converting into PR into Ariba, ECC PR to EC, Ariba PR?
So as I said, Ariba in sourcing, we only deal with, you know, quotation, bidding, RFQ. So we cannot have, at least with sourcing, we cannot have PR to PR automation or PR to PR. In sourcing, we don't have any PR or any PO.
Yeah. Okay. Karthik, I'm just detailing it. I had the same question as you. I mean, when we initially saw this, I think what Rakesh explained is quite answering. But maybe in case if we have procurement in Ariba procurement on demand installed, I mean, activated for a customer, then I don't know. I mean, in my logic, then maybe we can send the PR to PR. Is it correct, Rakesh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're right, Kasi. I mean, we can do that. If in case of downstream or in case of buyer, if you have any requirement to, you know, create PO from PR, you can create PR in Ariba in ECC, and you want to flow that as a PO in system, in sourcing, we can do that. We are actually doing that for a client, Canadian client. We are doing that. Hello.
Rakesh, yes, I have a small screen. So do you mind double clicking on the home button in the Visio so I can see it a bit bigger?
Yeah, sure.
The
Is this fine?
No, if you move your mouse to the issue home button there, that's the home, no? The menu
Sorry?
button. You can just double click.
Yeah.
If you move up, go up, double click there. Yes. Because my screen is smaller here, you know. Yeah, this is better.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Is it visible now?
You know, now it's visible. Now, I mean, now I can see it better. Yeah.
So, shall I continue?
Yeah, please continue. Thank you.
Yeah. So, sourcing request is created in solution. It will again, if required, it will go for approval, if any. So, once project owner reviews and approves, it will be created as a sourcing project. So there is a thin line between creation, I mean sourcing request to sourcing project. There must be some owner review and approval. Approval is not required, but review has to be done depending upon the business requirement. It will create event. Now the same process, sourcing project, like choose the type of event, type of template. So this is the master data of Ariba solution. This is the master data of SAP ECC. So real-time synchronization will be there. Real-time in the sense, as I said, we'll have scheduled tasks. If you want to update it on a daily basis, you can do it daily basis. If you want to update it as a whatever, however you want, you can do that. Apart from that, if you want at a time, like daily on a daily basis, I have set a scheduled task, but I want it to be updated now. I mean now. So you just click on scheduled task. It will be automatically updated. This data will be updated. So master data real time synchronization is there. So you can pull the master from master data, like line items. You can pull the line items, you can pull the vendors from master data. Yeah, so after selecting the line items or suppliers, so suppliers, as I said, we have different types of supplier identification, like inviting the supplier who is already in system. Those are nothing but approved suppliers of solution. These are all approved suppliers, right? And supplier identification is like posting in discovery. Now we publish the event. After that, we have when the event is published, we can have supplier bidding. So these are all the supplier who are invited through Ariba discovery. So supplier response on request acceptance. The supplier response is related to the discovery posting. So once he is posting, he is accepting the discovery posting, he can participate in event. So once the event is published, you can see supplier accept the prerequisite of the event. So I did not get chance to show you. Whenever we send any notification to supplier, event notification, event invitation, so it will go as a prerequisite acceptance. You need to accept the prerequisite, which includes the legal term, or if you want to include any legal term, it will be included. If you want to have some, non-disclosure agreement, NDA, you can have that. So all these prerequisite, if you want to add some prerequisite from your organization, and you can have that. So once he is accepting all those, he'll be able to participate in the bidding, right? Now,
so Rakesh, I have a question, Rakesh.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, can you please scroll up a bit? I think I'm able to follow the buyer side of it generally. The question is, so I understand the sourcing request is created, which ideally should be similar in Ariba to a sourcing project. or associate event. Yeah.
Yeah.
So when you say project owner reviews it, that means for a sourcing project, for a sourcing request, you have a reviewer or approval there, is it?
Yeah. So sourcing request and sourcing project is something different. Sourcing request is generally, you know, when any request coming from other third party to third party application, so it will be coming as a request from third party. So this request will be reviewed by the application reviewer, application, I mean, whoever, project reviewer. So he'll review and convert it into.
But how would you know who is the project reviewer? Because the sourcing request is just coming online to you.
No, the project reviewer from your organization, the buyer organization, somebody should be there, right? I mean, like project, the person who is creating the project, he'll be the project reviewer. Could be the project. He's just a user.
But he's a user. For example, I'm the project owner. Okay.
Yeah.
You created a. You are sitting somewhere in one of the plants. Okay. I belong to procurement department.
Yeah.
So I'm a purchasing manager or whatever. Let's say. So obviously, when you created an RFQ, and when the RFQ goes to a particular status, like I don't know, saved or whatever, then it flows through to Ariba and automatically create a sourcing request, right? So on the same day, I may have 20 different sourcing requests getting created. How would I physically know there is 10 or 20 different items coming in, sourcing requests coming in?
10 or different sourcing requests coming into.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just exaggerating the example by making it more complicated. Even for a simple case, even this is one sourcing request. I mean, there must be somebody to tell me outside the system. Our system must send me a notification. The system has to send me a notification. How does the system know who to send the notification to?
See, I mean, we can assign, we can, I'll tell you real-time example of this. We are implementing a project for one company who have three different systems, three different ECC. But they bought only one solution, one Ariba solution. Now comes the, this is the perfect example for your question. So what happens, I have three different ECC and is integrated to only one application, that is Ariba sourcing. Now, I have to accommodate all these three verticals. They have three verticals, by the way, three different companies altogether. So I have to accommodate all these three company users into Ariba solution. One is for mining industry, one is transportation industry, one is something else, whatever. So manufacturing industry. So I have to take all the users, I mean key users from ECC, and I have to accommodate in sourcing. Now when I'm creating sourcing request from ECC solution, when I am creating sourcing request or RFQ from ECC solution and sending it as a request to sourcing, now comes the picture to whom it should go to, right? Scenario perfectly suited, because we have different vertical in same solution. Now we should specify to whom it should go to. So in that case, we have a purchase organization. We can map in such a way like using purchase organization or commodity code, company code. Generally we match in here, we mapped with company code, where the users will be mapped with company code. So when I am creating from manufacturing industry company code, that will go to the manufacturing industry company code users only. Got my point?
Okay. So I understand. That means at the time of sending the sourcing request itself, I understand that at the time of creating, sending the data for the web services itself, you will also mention from ECC who is the guy in Ariba to receive this request as a project owner.
Specify the organization code. But you know, the specifying of this user will be done in Ariba itself. If company code is so and so, I mean request coming from company code so and so, you will be responsible. So that definition will be done in our Ariba solution.
But where would you, I mean, is it something that you can do as part of consulting, or where do you mention it, or do you mention it in the workbook?
No, I mean we can do also, but generally Ariba guys don't want us to do. They generally take the ownership and do that. Generally, but we can also.
How would
do
we? Okay, got it. Got it. Can you if you can show that item, this clarity will be very good, you know.
Which one?
If you show the place where there is a setup.
The place where you design groups and all, right? There only we can do
yes,
that.
Correct.
I'll show you a creation of user and all. So there only we can do
no,
that.
Oh, in the creation of user itself, we can say for this company code and this commodity code, he's the project owner or something like that, is it?
Yeah, yeah. I'll show,
okay,
I'll show
great.
You.
Sure. Okay. Thank you. Okay.
So is that clear? And this is very complex example. I mean, I think this is not at all required when you are creating a reviewer. Kasi, are you with me?
Yes, I'm on mute. I'm with you, yes.
Yeah, thanks. So that is very complex a scenario, but generally when we create any RFQ from ECC, right? So it, you know, it will go for reviewer. So for entire organization, the project reviewer or the procurement reviewer or a sourcing request reviewer will be only one. So all those will go to that person, and that person's ID will be mapped. So he'll have the to-do task on that. So he has to review on daily basis or whatever. So he has to do that.
Yeah. But now, what's happening is, see, I implemented SRM for one of the company some many years ago, like 6-7 years ago. So, so in that implementation, we collect the different purchase requisition into SRM sourcing request, but what naturally happened was after we have gone live, it was found out that this online procurement system had made the business more effective, which made loads of purchase requisitions to come in, and it's really loaded the procurement team. So what
in
they want
that,
to have is they want automate.
In that case, we can have multiple reviewers.
Yeah, so what they did is they wanted to have, multiple reviewers, but I mean, from IT perspective, it is just a reviewer is a name. But in real time, he's an employee to the company it's a commitment to the company and more expense to the procurement team.
Mm-hmm.
What happened is we have about 8,000 different offices within Malaysia for this power company, and each office have their own users who are able to create purchase requisition. What happens is if everything comes inside, no? I mean, the procurement team has like only like 13, 14 people. But after implementation, if you get to know, hey, since we implemented this online procurement solution, we need to hire two more people. But nobody's happy about it, you see. That's exactly the reason why we were invited again, not invited, we were complained to have suggested the online procurement system. And then we did something called as workload management. And we were doing some, I cannot remember what was it, we were doing some tricks to find out the current workload of each of the purchasing team and start assigning to the request to different teams based on various rules. And the first rule could be just based on the commodity code, for example, or a commodity, I mean, in ECC, it is called a material group or service group. Based on that and based on the load, and a lot of things actually. That was like another small project. So I'm just worried the same scenario could happen if we are not able to control to who it has to go automatically.
Exactly. So I'll do one thing. I'll convey the same message to my project manager and ask him to find some solution. This is actually a good,
this really happened, and I tell you that the most shocking thing is the customer was completely upset, and they do not want to give a new project or change or whatever. They demanded this to be done because we are the one who proposed the solution, and we should also have told them what changes could happen in a company because of implementing the online solution. You see.
Okay. Yeah, sometimes happens even people do that. I mean, organization will blame that you suggested it, but this is not working out. Something like that. Yeah. Even for sourcing, we claim that you can save at least 8% of your annual spend directly in within a year of implementing Ariba, and that doesn't work out now. The company start working this idea and so on.
But now SAP nicely will show only the positive type of things.
Let's get into these Visio ones.
Okay.
I think Karthik is getting bored, because of conversation. Sorry, Karthik.
Sorry, Karthik. Karthik, is it really not in your interest, Karthik?
No.
I'm...
Karthik, are you there?
Yeah, it's okay.
So yeah, I published the event. Now it's in preview parade. It could be in preview parade or it could be in pre-bidding parade, where buyer will in preview parade, but at the same time supplier will review the bid and analyze the bid content, like what are the line items I got for this event. He'll just review and just sort of analyzing. Once he's analyzed, he submit bids. As I said, there will be real-time synchronization in monitoring the bids. You can see the bids on your screen while the supplier is submitting. So once the supplier is submitting the bid, we can monitor the event. After... So after he submits the bid end time comes, we analyze the bid and define the award scenario. As I said, this is must. We have to have a award scenario in place. So once we award that, we select a supplier and award that, and it will go for approval for award. If any approvals are required for awarding to that supplier, it will be going to that approval. So this is for my current client, so they want approval for award to supplier. So once it is done, the supplier is awarded, and the same, if you want, you can create an outline agreement using this, or if you want to create, you can create direct PO from this. So they don't want any outline agreement, they are not using any outline agreement, so they want directly a PO to be created. So again, if any release strategy is there, it will go for release, that is approval. Then PO is released, purchase order is released. So this is the complete process. Any doubts in this? This is Ariba solution part. So buyer is nothing but our client. Here it's denoting the client. The solution is Ariba solution itself, but here buyer is buyer and supplier, client and the vendor. So he's denoting in that way. Is everything okay, Kasi?
Yeah. I just got disconnected and came back.
Okay.
Do you mind also quickly? I know we are not getting into administration, but do you mind also showing the exact place? Because that will start coming in my mind for this commodity codes and purchasing group and company code mapping.
Here we cannot do because this is our sourcing system, right? I mean partner demo, right? Here we should have exact details to whom with match. If I get chance, I'll
Okay.
So sure, keep sure, it sure. with okay. you. I'll get back to you, Kasi. Keep it with you. I'll definitely get back to you on this.
Sure. Okay. Sure.
Okay. So let's complete our template designing. So is that okay? I mean the process. So I am able to explain this external system integration, right?
Yeah.
So template is generally, for sourcing request also we have template which needs to be integrated with external system. So that's the reason we have external system integration for templates also. Now, yeah, so this is about overview. Now here, we can create an event. Like, as I said, I have a one template. If I'm extending the template and creating a full project, whatever documents I am creating here whatever document I am creating here will be reflected over there in the full project. Will be creating the full project using this template will be created. So
Rakesh, one thing we did not cover is how do you mention which field needs to be enabled, which field needs to be disabled?
Yeah, that I'll show you. So now I'm creating, Karthik, please pay attention. I'm creating one event inside a full project, right? I'm creating one event inside a full project. I'm giving the name is demo. So my template name is 18 and creating event is demo 18 for 18. Demo event for 18. So it's a test event. Taking yes. I'm not specifying commodity. I'm not specifying anything. I'm just taking it as auction. Right. I'm creating. See, Kasi. Now here comes. All these are event rules. All these are events. Excuse me. Hello.
Yeah. I'm listening. I'm seeing this here. Sure.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, meeting my partner. Yeah, sorry. It was called Kasi. So. Now we can this is the similar we saw in the event, right? Timing rules. Now we have option called delegation, read only, hidden. I'll explain you about three. Delegation is nothing but if you keep it as delegated, it will be populated in our system as the end user, the person who is creating the event can delegate it or can use it. Karthik, are you online? I think Kasi is disconnected.
Yes, I'm there, Rakesh.
Yeah, I think he got disconnected. I think he is getting connected. He lost his audio, it seems. Are you able to see his message, Kasi? Kartik?
Yes, yes, Rakesh.
Yeah.
Let me come current patch.
So how is your work going on? I mean, are you into some Ariba project, or are you just learning out of your curiosity?
No, I just got into Ariba project. Maybe it's an implementation phase. So
okay.
Maybe I just joined a week back into Ariba project from SRM.
Okay. So you are into the project, or you are expecting some project to be assigned?
No. I'm already inside Ariba. 1 week back.
So which module it is? Okay, which module it is?
Actually, Merck, the project is Merck.
Okay.
And it has humans. The humans, I don't know. But only 1 week it has been started. So through my manager,
okay,
I got
okay.
into the project.
Any doubts regarding projects, let me help you out, okay?
Sure.
Yeah. Kasi, are you back?
Rakesh, can you go back one second?
Yeah. Kasi, are you back? Yeah, you can go ahead. Kartik.
Yeah, I didn't understand about this delegated. Can you tell me, please?
Yeah, I'll explain you. I'll explain you these three things. Let him come. I'll explain you.
Sure, sir.
Okay.
Sure, sir. So, Rakesh, coming to yesterday's class, I have one doubt. Actually, yesterday we created a full project.
Yes.
Creating full project, we have created templates related to full project.
Now, today.
Yesterday.
No, template we are creating today. Yesterday we didn't create any template. We
no,
selected one
we
template
have,
related
selected,
to full project.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
We have selected a template, a full project template. There are many full project templates, and sometime back you have created one demo template and you have selected one, is it?
Yeah, yes.
So, okay, but when we are creating quick project, we were directly selecting the event. Sorry, we are directly
after
selecting a template.
After selecting event also, we are selecting one template.
No. In quick project, first we have created, we have selected quick project, and there were RFI, RFP, and auction. There were event type option, and depending on those event types, if we have selected RFI event, so RFI templates were displaying, RFP, RFP templates were displaying, auction templates were displaying. So we are directly selecting those templates according to the event type.
Yes,
but when it is for full project, we have some templates for full projects, and we have selected full project template, and then we have in after going inside, we have selected event type, and in the event type we have selected again template.
Yes, perfect. So what happens when you creating a event or any sourcing project, it will ask for you full project or quick project, right? So when you select full project, only the templates related to full project will be visible. When you select quick project, so again it will ask, it won't show any template. It will ask which type of event it is. If you select RFI, the templates related to RFI will be visible. If you select RFP, the templates related to RFP will be visible. If you select auction, only the templates related to auction will be visible. So this is how it goes on, right? Now, if you are creating an event inside a full project, again, it's like creating quick project. You have to select one template according to the event type, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So am I clear with you?
Yes. So now today, so today we are creating a template for full sourcing project. Is it?
Yeah, full project.
Okay. Actually, thing is, because of these questions and just getting carried away, because of these questions and getting focused on those questions.
No, I'm happy. I'm happy because this. I mean,
No.
This is the acknowledgement of. Yeah, concept.
Yeah. Thing is, like we are going in the flow, and just some pop. Yeah, I'm all capable getting popped up into some question, and I could not remember. Okay, what we were doing.
Yeah. Okay. So, in what way should we do? Shall we go in this manner? Like, you know, I'll explain. I'll go with my flow. At the end, you can ask question one by one. Yeah, is that good way? Yeah. Or we shall continue.
I'm thinking in that way only. Like, if any question pops up, we just note down in the book or paper, and at the end of the session or about to end, then we can, you know, ask questions that will give an idea. I'm thinking this way is good, but I don't know how KP responds.
Yeah, so actually, both way are good. Sometimes what happens, some doubts are so curious that won't allow you to, you know, understand the future concept or coming concept. So in that
such kind of doubts are okay.
We'll do that. I'll suggest Kasi also to do that, do same. So Kasi, just ping me if you are not able to hear me or if you have any issues. You're able to see my screen as well, I think so. Yes. Yeah. So now comes this you are asking about delegation, right? So this is the event which will, just a moment, yeah, so which will be there in while you create an event, you can see the same dashboard, same rules, timing rules, suppliers, content. The team will be available because we are defining the team inside the full project. So that team will be applicable to the event also. Now comes the rules. If you want to make it delegated in the sense, if I will keep it as delegated, then the user who is creating the event can use this option, like can change this option. If I put it as read only, so and I am putting is no, and if I put at this as read only, then what happens? He won't be able to change it, but the field will be visible, but he won't be able to change this field. It will be no, that's it. That's a read only access to this field. If I put it as hidden, then it will be shown as, it will be, the option will be no and it will be hidden. The field will be not visible to the end user for at the time of creation. So these are the three types of field setting we have.
Which field, Rakesh?
This field. See, every field have this delegation. If I'm using about this field, okay. So every field has these options. You can see. Every field has this option.
Okay.
Got my point, right?
Yeah.
Now, depending upon the requirement, we can set rules priorly. And see, at the time of we are creating bidding rules, we did not see these many fields in that actual. See, the market feedback, you can see at the time of auction, you did not see these many market feedback fields. So all those can be, you know, managed by the template and these three options.
So all those fields were hidden in the template.
Yeah, the template which I selected, so the fields which are not visible were hidden, or some fields were, you know, read only, which we cannot change. And here we can see message board settings. If you want to have any message board settings, we can have. So all these fields are self-explanatory. You need not to have no deep explanation for that. Like allow participant to send message to the project team. Yes, no, or
okay. So Rakesh, can you hear me, Rakesh?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. After using the template to create the event, how does my reviewer know, reviewer for example, know which template was used to create this event?
Sorry, come again, I get you.
How does a reviewer know which template was used to create this event?
See, templates are pre-approved. I mean, before creating project only, we have to approve the template, right?
I understand. I am giving you a real-time scenario. Real-time scenario is there are some common approvers for 10 different templates because okay. He's a mandatory person. Okay. So, but I know that one of the templates will allow the suppliers to see the baseline price, let's say that, okay? The other template does not allow it. So me as the approver for all 10 different templates, I need to know which template have you chosen that will help me to decide either to approve or to reject. Because you could simply pick up a wrong template, which could be just variant of one field, but that is going to break the whole tender process.
So, I never came up this scenario, I mean, regarding, because generally what happens when we create event, like, you know, RFI event, so only RFI templates will be visible. So association of this template to any project, I think it will be there in overview. I never saw that. We'll check, Kasi, we'll check. Okay.
Okay.
See, are you there?
Yeah. Okay, sure. I have to mute.
Yeah. So I'll definitely check it out. So now moving ahead to the field setting. So this is how we can set the fields and all. So are we clear on this delegation of the field or setting of fields? Is that clear?
Can you please scroll up and can you switch to some other tab please on the left side, navigation?
Yeah, supply. So here we cannot have suppliers because you know supplier is something we have to invite at the time of event. So we can have some basic line items where we are not disclosing price. We can have line items or lots. We are not disclosing price. So mainly we can play around with the template is, you know, rule setting up rules and conditions. So conditions will be added for a full project, not for a quick project. As I already explained, conditions,
what is mean by condition?
I mean, sorry?
What is mean by conditions? I remember having seen this in the templates.
Yeah. So I'll show you the condition tab, how we create conditions. How we associate that with events or tasks or any documents. I'll show you. Because a quick project or an event cannot have conditions because they don't have any documents, the approval flows or tasks. They don't have any such tasks to associate with any conditions or we'll just create one project. We'll quickly have a response of supplier and review that and close it. So that's the reason. But in full project, we have complete capability, project management capability. In that case, we can have conditions
I'll show you.
So this is the event I have created demo event for 18. So this is the auction event we created inside a template. So when I extend this template and create project, it will be automatically there in that project. And depending upon the requirement, like I can manage this event from here itself. I don't need not to go that. I mean, while creating the project, I need not to do double work or work hard for this event. Now, for suppose let's create some conditions. Yeah. So, Kasi, you remember the example I gave yesterday regarding transportation?
Yes, regarding the transportation, and you have sub questions for sea transportation and different questions for air transportation, etc.
Exactly.
I remember that.
Yeah, exactly. So in the same way, I can have some questions like let us take the same example. Let us take a rough example. I'll give you one real-time scenario as well, and what is the requirement. So let us take what. Arti, just interrupt me wherever you require. Okay? So I am creating one question, adding some answers to this, drop-down answers. So I am setting as default must be changed so that sometimes we require this type of options, like select one is the option, but we require end user to change that to any of this answer. Now we can define a condition, like I created a question. I just created question. Now in document, I'm selecting condition like, okay, for this event only visible when the condition is set to sea transport event. I mean the answer is sea transport when we selecting the questions, right? These questions are there, right? These questions are there, right? What is the mode of transport? So when people select, when end user select sea transport, so in documents only this event should be visible. Think that I have multiple events, like I have 10 events, but when I select in answer C transport event, only this should be applicable, right? Only this should be visible. Rest of the thing should not be visible. When I select, well, while creating another project, I selected air transport. So the event which is related to air transport, only those should be visible. So in that way, we can associate this template, I mean these conditions, to any document. At the same time, we can have tasks, we can create. Any doubts in this? I'll go to task.
I'm fine actually. This is good. So basically, I can add as many number of questions as I like and attach to those events. And I can have questions which are not attached to any conditions, which will be visible for all the parties.
Yes. Sometimes we might require this type of condition. So this is one. I'll give another example once we are done with this. Karthik, are you fine?
Yes, Rakesh.
So now, in the same way, we can create a task. We can assign this task to any document, or we can assign any condition to this task. First of all, I'll select phase. How I said you, right? We can have different phases, like plan phase. We can set rank, like what should be the rank of this phase. Rank is something, you know, which will decide who should be going first. Like plan phase, in plan phase, if you are setting rank 10, then it will execute first. If you are setting 20 rank, then second phase will, the phase which is rank set 20 will be executing next. So the rank is nothing but, you know, aligning it in a manner, I mean proper manner. So is it a recurring schedule or not? We can fix it as well. I mean, it's keep on recurring or not. Predecessor, as I said, predecessor project or predecessor phase is something, you know, where any phase that led to the creation of this phase, any previous phase which led to the creation of this phase, if any, we can also associate that phase with this. So I'm creating this phase, plan phase. Inside plan phase, we can create task, to-do task. I'm giving it as approval task. So all these are information which need to be filled, like a project owner, observer, if you want to put due date. So due date will be like depending upon the parent phase. If it's under a phase, so once the phase is started, how many days after it should, the due date, it should be there. So I'm taking 15 days as due date. We can set milestone. Once milestone is reached, it will notify the project owner or any team member if associated with this template or project. So I'm not selecting any milestone. If you want to select, you can. If you are assigning any milestone, we should give some date, like requires due date. So milestone is something, you know, notifying that, okay, we achieved this thing on, so if you are achieving this thing on so and so date, then it is a milestone. So we can set, if it's a due date, if it's before due date or requires due date, then it will be a milestone. So we can set if required, otherwise you cannot. I mean, we are not. Another option is like whether it is required or not. This task is required or not. I mean, is it mandatory or not to continue to the next task or next phase? You can even have that. Now comes the field setting. So this is I am doing because I have to set some condition. So I am setting field setting process to be approved. So I'll tell you why I did this. I'll tell you. So any doubts, just interrupt me. While telling maybe.
Rakesh,
yeah.
Plan phase comes after analyze phase, right?
So I just gave as a naming convention. This is not also that plan or analyze or sourcing phase. This is just, you know, a naming convention. Here I can give as, you know, my company phase or something like this is just a name. Maybe I don't want to analyze anything. I just directly want to plan and, okay, you know, buy. So it's not something related to solution. It's just a naming convention.
Rakesh, can you add a new task? Because I think I saw somewhere different types of tasks in some.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to show that?
Negotiation task, to-do task, notification task.
No. Can you click on the to-do task, please? One more to-do task, yeah? Please scroll down for me, please.
Kasi, have you changed your headphones?
Me, is it? You're talking to me? Yeah. I'm still on the, using the same headphones.
No, I'm asking, have you changed your headphones because your voice, sounding different.
Oh, no. I'm using the same headphones. Just that since I'm home, I don't use the office laptop. I realized that you were not hearing me through my headphones, but you are hearing me through the laptop headphone. Can you please scroll down and open the last item? The advanced task details, yeah. Notifications.
It's just a notification, like if anybody comments or anybody having any changes, if you want notification on comment.
Okay, because I have a requirement where the customer says you want to add a approval task for every event. Do you think you can do that?
Yeah. You can pretty much do that.
What does it mean, Rakesh? I didn't understand. Approval task for an event.
While creating an event, I'm sourcing project creator in a company. While creating an event, I am just an employee, but the approval should be there. I mean, there should be some approval from my higher management. Who is funding the amount, who will be project sponsor. So while creating any event, we can have approval from the event sponsor. We can have the approval from, for suppose you are an employee in a procurement company, you are employee, but while you are creating any event, that should need approval from your finance manager or CEO or MD, whatever. So once it is approved, we create the project, we go for bidding, we select one supplier. Again, when we are submitting for award, if you want to have approval at the time of awarding also, we can have approval while awarding.
Awarding, I think it's okay. I mean, you are showing that it was showing like parallel serial and something like this, right? But can you do it for individual task?
Task in the sense I didn't get you.
Yes. I have a task which says one of the items in my tender is to show the company's organizational structure. Okay.
Okay.
So this will be a new, basically creating an organizational structure in perspective of tender is not a straightforward process. It could take 10 days or 15 days to do it. I don't know, maybe it could be longer also. So this task is, it is a task that is assigned to, for example, yeah, project secretary, let's say that, okay. This project secretary, when he or she, I mean, in my case, it's a she, when she creates a project organizational structure, he has to get that approved before it can internally become an officially completed task.
Okay.
So I have hundreds of tasks. One of the tasks is to create project organization structure.
Okay.
This is being created by, for example, Akasi. And Kasi is going to create it in a PowerPoint or whatever, but he requires his manager to approve it to have the status completed for the task. That is exactly the requirement I have.
Okay. So you can have, you know, approval for creating organization structure. But here it's just a task where we are mentioning that, okay, this task is completed or not. What is the status of the task? I mean, just to, you know, make it, it's like diary. We are writing, okay, I have to do points. I have to do these all points. Okay, I have done the first point. I have done the second point. Check it. So, but actually you're not doing that thing in the diary. You're doing somewhere physically or somewhere in the system. Right, but you are just mentioning, okay, I done this task today 1 p.m. I done this task tomorrow. I'll do this task tomorrow 2 p.m. progress. So we are just maintaining that in our system and in our Ariba project. So that's the reason it's called as project management. We manage our project using this task.
Okay, so you can have only a to-do task and notification task.
Negotiation task, notification task. If you want to send any notification, you can mention some tasks regarding that.
There is no explicit approval for individual task. Instead, it should be done outside the system. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, got it.
So, shall we move ahead? Yeah, so where were we? Oh yeah, creating new to-do task. You asked me to create, okay. So as I said, it as a milestone, it is, you know, showing it, this symbol represent milestone, as I set it as a milestone. Now, okay, now what? Creating condition, yeah. I'm actually losing that pace, I mean, you know, the continuous. Here we can create condition. Like there we just created question, right? And I added that question answer to the event. Now here we can actually create the condition like approval task. This is the name of the condition, okay? Name of the condition, and this condition can be associated with task. Don't get confused, we are adding approval flow or approval flow to the task. This is the condition we are adding to the task. I mentioned this. So now, generally we have three different types of condition matching, I mean condition adding, like field match. Field match is something where we will match the fields which are available in the solution. I mean this, like if you are creating a sourcing project event, so fields of event, RFA event will be visible. Fields of RFP event will be visible when while creating condition. So reference to a condition means you have already one condition in place. If you want to refer to that condition, you can do that. Subcondition means I created one condition. Again, in that condition, like I created one field match condition. Again, under that, I want to create another field match condition. So these are types of conditions we have. So these all three types of conditions are known as expression condition, condition on expression. And the question one, which we did it, right? The question answer, question answer, that is known as response condition. Like, I mean, the response condition is something where somebody needs to give to, I mean, somebody has to give some response to that question, then only it will, you know, go with some condition. So that is response condition. All these are expression condition. We have to create expression for this. For example, I am taking a field match condition. Now, it's asking for select a field. Okay, I'll go with. purchase group, purchase organization. Yeah. Let's take, okay, I am selected condition company code. When company code is equal to, here also we can have some condition like when company code is equal to or is null, is not null, is null, or contains, ends with, equals to. So all these are conditions, I mean expression. This is the expression actual. So when the company code is equal to, I don't have appropriate company codes over here. Generally in system we can have see, it's showing if, because I don't have any proper company codes, he's asking for select external system. So if we have integration in place, we can select, or if we have any data, master data in place, we can select. So what we can do is, like, you know, we can select company code which is available in the system. So the condition will be like, when the company code is equal to so and so, so this condition will be activated. And the condition we can add it to the task, like okay.
No, Rakesh, if this condition becomes true, then what happens?
Then we can associate this with, I'll show you. I'm taking another condition because I don't have company codes. I'm just taking, okay, event type.
Didn't get displayed. Like event.
Sorry?
Event type select some event type.
Yeah, so see, I'll tell you, I selected event type. This is the field type. Okay, and selected event type. When event type is equal to auction, it's showing in number, and event type is equal to auction is my condition. Now I selected this condition, so this condition is created. It's not okay. So let's say that so what I did is, and when the event, I created one condition, approval condition, right? When the event type is equal to auction, this plan phase should automatically start, or this plan phase can be started, proceeded. So my example might be not correct, I mean appropriate example, but I'll do one thing, I'll show you this in a different system.
Rakesh. Rakesh, from the implementation perspective, I understand implementation perspective, we do all these things in the test landscape or test tenant itself, and we show the demo or we show it to the
Can you see my
customers.
screen? Can you see my screen?
No.
You're not able to see my
Okay.
screen, right?
Unable to see, yes.
Okay, go ahead, go ahead.
Okay. So from implementation perspective, let's assume that we have done it, okay, in the test tenant, okay, and showed the customers and we got an agreement. To move it
Okay.
to production tenant, we have to tell SAP to move it. But when we move it, SAP, will they also move the templates? Because templates, I believe, for my customer, I may be having too many templates. Okay. I cannot imagine redoing everything again in production.
Everything will be moved. I mean, you need not to do redundant work. Everything will
Yeah.
be moved from test to production. That is their headache. I mean, we need not to panic on that side.
Okay, so all
Then
what we need to do is we need to verify only what needs to be there in production is existing in the test, yeah?
yes. So we just need to have a sign off from client. They'll be moving after client sign off, they'll move test to production. Yeah, so let me
Okay,
show.
got it.
Now, can you see my screen?
No.
Still.
No, Rakesh. Rakesh, after the implementation phase gets completed, so we need to test the application from if we are implementation partner, we have to test it.
No, implementation means before implementing only you have to test it, not after implementation. Before implementation only you have to do UAT along with the client. It's not only you do the UAT. You have to do the UAT along with the client. It might be client place, it might be remote. So
So
you have to do it.
mostly how it is? Is it a client location mostly?
So that again depending upon the client's budget, project budget or implementation cost. So sometimes if it's in India, generally they used to send, I mean, it's not that much cost just sending consultant to the client place. But if it comes to the abroad, then they might think, okay, we just try to do UAT from remote. Maybe it save the cost, something like that. So that is again business requirement or company's commercial term.
Okay.
So is my screen is visible now?
More actually.
No,
Is
Rakesh.
it?
No, cannot see.
Now,
No.
oh, what happened? It's showing me as is sharing, stop sharing your screen, something like that. I don't know what happened.
Okay, can we have a 10 minutes of break?
Yeah. We'll do that. Asi, shall we have a break?
Yeah, please go ahead. I mean, I will still be there because I have to finish together and go out. And I'll recommend
Okay.
it very later.
How much time you have? I mean,
No. I'm okay, guy. I'm okay, actually. Once I finish these things, I hope we can finish in the next 1 hour. Is it okay? Should be
yeah,
longer.
we'll do that. Kartik, we'll be finishing by 1 hour. You just go and take a 5 to 10 minutes break. We'll be back and we'll finish by 1 hour. Okay, in meanwhile, I'll check with this.
Meanwhile, I'm just trying to get that document out. I'm looking for the document.
Yeah, we'll do that, please.
That's a quite interesting one, you know. I couldn't find it. When they told me, when I spoke to them, I had taken note of that. That was in my laptop and it's synchronized.
Still, you are not able to see my screen, Kasi?
No, still unable to see it. Because I asked these questions in terms of reports, the responses. So Guam is there. In our project, we directly create, the sourcing already exists. Sourcing is already used by the customer. Hello?
Yeah, I'm here, go ahead.
Yeah, the sourcing is already used by the customer. We have been using it for a few years already. So we have proposed to have the PR, because we have P2P also. The PR also created in Ariba itself, because we just have some issues with the licensing in ECC. And then from purchasing, we will go to sourcing. And from sourcing, an award, it will either go to PO or contract, and then it goes to receipt, RPO, and then receipt. Followed by invoice and remittance. But remittance, I don't know what the hell is this remittance all about. This remittance, they say this remittance is happening in ERP. I think remittance is reconciliation.
Remittance and all, I think ECC, this is there for past. Right?
Yeah, okay. So I read that part. Ariba applications, and then from connectivity perspective, we are doing using web services to do the material master and PI to send. Oops, this is no. We are using PI to send and material master. Supplier master is also included, purchasing org is included, company code, group, plant, purchasing organization.
Still not able to see my screen.
Hang on. No, still unable to see. Rakesh, that should be okay for you to just go back in your browser. Once you go back, you'll be lost the connectivity. And then you go to a meeting and then join back again. Then it should be okay. Hello, Rakesh, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Is it visible now?
No, not yet, not yet. Rakesh, still not visible, right?
Yeah, I think I'm not presented now. I think SAP need.
Okay, now you are no longer a presenter. Okay, got it. Now that is, yeah. Okay, do you also have any field class implementation?
Hello? Yeah, Kashi.
Yeah, sure.
Hello, yes, Sai, actually
yeah.
I logged out this time, so now I cannot share my screen. Can you ask anybody to make me presenter? No, I'm just on here. So ask them to make me presenter.
Okay. It's showing 2 and 3 sudo.
Yeah, every time you go back and come forward, it adds up the name.
Now what to do with this? I want to delete this.
No. Once you log out properly, I think it some 90 minutes or something, it automatically closes. Once the presenter log on, once the organizer logs out, 90 minutes,
okay.
Everybody will be killed, I think. 90 minutes or 60 minutes. Okay. So we don't
have
to
want to close this? Close this window completely and re-log in.
No. For presenting, once it, now I can see your screen. Yes, that's all.
Yeah.
So we continue to do everything as it is. Just that once Sai logs off, in certain
okay.
time, after certain time, it automatically closes all the sessions.
Okay. So I am new to this GoToMeeting. We generally use WebEx.
Yeah.
So give me 5 minutes, Kasi. I'll be back.
Sure. No
minutes.
Problem. Please take. Sure, please go ahead.
Kasi, are you there?
Yes, I am here. I am here. Yes.
Karthik, are you back?
Yes, Rakesh, I'm there.
Are we good to start? I mean, we can start.
Yeah.
So I think now you can see my screen, right, Karthik, Kasi? So I was trying to explain you about the template condition, how we use. So I'll show you a real-time request from the client where it asks for So this is a template which is, you know, to integrate a request, Ariba ECC RFQ, sourcing request and sourcing project. So I have a condition stating that is approved condition. So I have a condition stating that when this this task is approved with this condition, then only I should be able to see this sourcing project. Otherwise, this sourcing project should not be available. See, this is the condition I added here. So is approved, in is approved condition, we give the expression like when it should be, I mean, when it should come into picture and what should happen. This is the scenario, like I gave condition like, okay, my process status field should be equal to approved. So this is the field, this is the response of the end user, like approved or not. So when the process status field is equal to approved, the name of the condition is this, should be active. And what it should, after activating, it should make this document visible. It should make this document, this sourcing project, visible. So now the flow is like, you know, I got a sourcing request from ECC. I got a sourcing request. This is a sourcing request template. So once I got the request, the process status should be approved. That means somebody has to go and approve the process status field once he get the task, to do task. As I said, this, as soon as he get this to do task, he approves that task, this project status, then this sourcing project will be visible. Otherwise, the sourcing project won't be visible to the end user to create. So this is what
So for the documents, to be available in the documents tab, are all documents available under document tab, these conditions, we set in conditions tab.
Yeah, we can set a condition tab so that, you know, we can set the visibility of the document, or we can set the accessibility of the document.
So basically what all appearing here depends on the condition, true or false, which are available in conditions tab.
Yeah, if that is the requirement, we can set that condition. That is, as I mean, if some company need that, if any company have that requirement, we can set. Otherwise, it's not mandatory to have condition. We can have, good to have condition, but if I don't need any requirement, I can see this sourcing project at any time without any condition if I don't have this condition in place. Got my point? It's not mandatory to have a condition, but if you require any visibility, you know, criteria, like I want to see this project only when this condition fulfills. So in that case, we can have.
Is that clear, Karthik?
No. For me, not so clear. Okay, it's approved. I understand. I understand. Can you go inside the role, please? Can you go inside the condition?
What condition?
Yeah. Please go into condition. Okay. Can you open up? So this. Can you open up the condition? Is approved, where the project status is equal to approved.
Yeah. So you want me to open this?
Yeah. Please.
Is that clear? I mean, from here, is it clear or you want me to open this?
No. Please open it, because see, when it is approved, it's visible to who?
Visible to the person who is creating the project. See, project reviewer might be different and project creator might be different. Project approver might be different. Got my point? Visible to the end creating the project. You got it or not?
Oh, you mean this is the template, right? Oh, okay, I got it. Okay, clear.
So in the same way, we can set Seeds company code. This is. See, when all are true, Seeds company code. So all these are Seeds company code available in the system. Seeds, as I said, three different companies. So all these Seeds company codes are available here. If company code is in list, all this, then this condition will be activated. I said you right. I mean, we can set a condition like company code coming from so and so. You can do it from template. From user also you can do, but that is a workaround. I mean, you can do from here as well.
Okay.
Okay. Anything else? Because I want to quickly close this. So any doubts in this, just let me know.
Rakesh, I did see there was something quick. What is it? Custom packs, is it? Can you please drop down? Just now I saw something. In the condition. In the conditions, I believe. I don't know where exactly what is. In the conditions. Can you click on add condition?
We cannot add conditions from here. The reason behind, we need to change the version. As I said, it's already active and it's applied to one project. We have to change the version of the template. Then only we can edit it. And the version here, it's already V2 version is in active state. So when we change it, it will go to version V3.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
for new project, this version V3 template will be available.
Okay, got it. Is it possible you can create a new version? Because I wanted to see exactly what is that custom facts, because you did explain few things.
And where did you? We can see in the demo site.
Okay, can you go to condition?
Custom fact.
Yeah. Condition.
Custom fact. Okay.
Custom fact. I believe I saw that just now. No, condition cannot be. Because this one, we are not creating a new version, so we cannot. Okay. Can you go to task? It's okay, no man. When I see it next time, I'll tell you. Because now I cannot. That's okay. We can proceed. I'll ask when we see it next time. Immediately, I'll ask.
Yes. Custom. Okay. So shall I close this now? I mean.
Yeah, please.
So this is what about template? I mean, creating conditions. No. Anything else? I wanted to explain you about types of events. but I don't think so it will be possible to complete it today. The designing and adding question to the template, yeah, it's done. Types of events in Ariba sourcing. Yeah, I'll do one thing. I'll forward you guys this document, types of events in Ariba sourcing. Just go through that. We have different types of sourcing in Ariba, like different types of events. When I say events, like RFP, RFI and auction, we have different types. Like in reverse auction, we have a Dutch reverse auction, extended reverse auction, bid transformation auction, TCO, total cost ownership auction, and index based auction. So I'll forward the document to you. Just go through that. Those are all, you know, business scenarios which are used. You just go through that, and if you have any doubt, just let me know. I'll explain those. Okay, so those are all descriptive one. I mean, depending upon the business scenario, we use those events. Just go through that. And don't worry, I mean, if you want me to explain in coming session, I'll explain as well if you require. But I don't think so that is required to give much stress on that. That is depending upon the business requirement, we can have different, as I said, Ariba will provide you some out-of-the-box standard templates. So if you want to use those, you can use. Otherwise, if you want to customize your own template, you can do so. So scoring and grading, I'll explain this. Yeah, so we can do this in SIPM because both are same as doing this scoring and grading in sourcing or doing it in SIPM, both are same because anyhow, end of the day, we are evaluating the supplier. So I'll show you scoring and grading and when we are in SIM or SIPM, right? Now user profile creation. Okay, I'll show you some basic profile creation or user creation or administration work. So any doubts in template designing?
No, we can proceed. I'm fine.
We are talking about local, I mean, language, right?
Rakesh, I think there is one more item that you said about template. No? When we pick up a template, it will ask some questions. Oh, yeah, I think you did explain that. That is by adding questions in the conditions tab, right? Okay.
So what's the time in Singapore, Kasi?
It is 1:30 here.
AM, is it?
1:30 noon. Yeah.
Okay, noon PM, okay. So there is not much difference in our time zone, I think, right? 2 or 3
yeah,
hours.
Not much. 2.5 hours, yes.
Okay. So yeah. From this you can change the language, change your default locale. So from this you can change the language of the solution. Okay.
Okay, got it.
No, you
and,
asked me, right?
Yeah, I got it. Got it. I got it. Thank you. Let's say after we go to production, if there is a requirement, for example, there is a requirement to change some wordings, for example, for a particular language, we change it. I mean, we in the sense consulting company change it and request SAP to move it to production. Is it?
See, changing in the words means the standard wordings won't be changed, like no sourcing project cannot be changed, event auction cannot be changed. Those five custom fields are there, right? So if there is any changes to those, we can, I mean, the SAP can do it. But these are all, you know, shared by the every organization who is going sourcing. So it cannot be changed even for your particular domain.
No, I got it. I'm talking about the translations. Translations are usually for transactional data, like the name of the RFI, name of the RFP, that type of thing.
Okay. So those are also will be, you know, standard only. I mean, standard for to that language, to that locale, it will be standard. It's like same, like the translation, like you are seeing in sourcing project in English. So in Chinese, it will be the same sourcing project translated. So it cannot be changed because in China, there might be using so many.
No. I mean to say, see, I do not want to change the labels. I want to change the sourcing name, sourcing event name. For example, event name could be implementation of supply chain project. That could be the name, which is
okay.
In English it is different, and Chinese it is different. That is specific to the project itself. After we go live, I'm creating an event, and for this event, I've given an English name, and it usually happens during the approval, they ask us to change the name of the event. When I change the name of the event, the description
and
also,
user
oh yeah, I think I got it. I got it now. Okay, clear,
yeah.
Clear. I got it now.
So, no manage. See, we have administration, we have core administration. So as I am a super, I have super admin roles, I can access this. Generally, I mean, every user cannot have all this. This is because we have complete solution suite. So that's the reason we can do that. I mean, we can see all this. So I'll show you basic user, how we create user. If you you already have any users, you can search from here. If you want to create user, just click on create. It's same for all the solutions like procurement, buyer, upstream, downstream, everything it will be same. Just give the user ID, name, just give the details, that's it. Okay, so once we are done with this, you can add groups to this. Add or remove groups. So all these are groups, out of the box groups which create, I mean, might be standard groups, it might be groups created by other partner companies to just test. See the Bigo test team. Yeah.
We export users from HR database also, right? What is that then?
Which user?
No, in our project, it is ongoing that they are exporting data from third party system or CDM, something called that HR database or HR system like that.
Okay.
So I don't know, like directly we create users here or we export from their third party system also?
Very good question. I mean, actually, we can create users, I mean, we can import users from third party as well.
Okay.
So for that, As I showed you the template, if you have some, for suppose you have some, where is that? Yeah, if you have some users in your system, in your third-party system, ERP system, so in that case, you can directly import those users to your Ariba application. How I'll tell you. So we can do that if this opens, I'll tell you. But yeah, we can at the same time, you know, pull the data from user data, organization hierarchy, you know, user data from ERP to our Ariba solution. We can pretty much do that. I mean, in case of this creating user in Ariba, we can directly pull the data from backend system. Is that clear?
Yeah,
Karthik.
Yeah. Yeah, how is it done through CSV files?
That's what I was showing you, how it is done, but it's not, yeah, now it rolls.
So there is a scheduled task which is
No, nothing like that. See, this is the template where we, you know, load, like ERP system has some users. So we have to, you know, accommodate in this template according to Ariba solution, the language which Ariba solution understands, like login ID, full name of that user, email address, phone number of that user. So which currency location he is located to. Every user must have this. I mean, default currency if you want to specify. So in this way we pull the data from ECC and accommodate in this template, right? So these are the groups like commodity manager, so we can assign the those groups to the user which we want to create. So if you are saying false, then it's not, he is not commodity manager. If you are saying true, then he is sourcing agent. So for single user, we can add multiple groups, multiple business groups. So this is how we, you know, send data from ECC login IDs to Ariba. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
I hope I answered you in a correct manner. Kasi, is that clear?
Yeah. I think I've seen this before because I attended the Ariba session for user management from SAP. So I think I've seen this. So I'm sort of okay.
So yeah, this is how we create users in Ariba individually. You want to pull data from ECC, you already have. You have to accommodate in a proper template and you can load it automatically. Just loading.
But Rakesh, I mean, I understand the creation of users, okay, and also the synchronization, etc. That's okay. Groups also, I understand, sort of what, I mean, it's a common thing, I understand that there are some standard delivered groups, and if you want, you can add some extra groups and attach roles into it. It's all things is clear. But when you say CATEC commodity manager, usually the commodity manager is not the same person. In the sense, they have controls on what commodity they can manage with you. Usually, like let's say, if there is 45 or yeah, sure. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah, so commodity manager is responsible for all the commodities which are there, or you want to specify some commodities to him, we can do that as well. So generally, commodity manager will be responsible for all the commodities existing in the, like a material master existing in the system, in Ariba perspective. So he is responsible for the all commodities.
But in case if I want to limit it, because see the guy who is doing here project means is construction, okay, the construction by itself is a multi-billion-dollar company, multi-billion-dollar business, and my customer is a conglomerate company, so they do a lot of other business also, so they do not want the same guy. I mean, they do not, for example, they do not want a services guy, the IT services guy, to see or manage the commodity of construction items. I mean, okay, it's like they have like 2 million materials and about 75,000 services. I mean, the construction alone, you see, because construction contains a lot of materials like paint, screw, fan, I don't know, whatever, steel, 3mm steel, 5mm steel, etc. Obviously, a service guy, an IT service guy, should not be doing all those things. I mean, right now they have a very, this is a great company. They have a very good infrastructure and also process where they identify people like who manages which groups of materials. And they also follow UNSTC standards.
You know the roles and responsibility of commodity manager, right? I mean, any commodity adding to the system, he has to manage, he has to approve, like in Ariba generally, catalog uploading.
You are right. So the person here should only manage construction related commodities which comes in, for example, 20-30 different groups. And they have this commodity standardized across locations because they do most of their construction projects in Middle East.
Yeah. So we can set rules using approval tasks, like, you know, assigning approval tasks like, okay, I have one commodity manager for the complete organization. Apart from that, I have a commodity manager for category wise commodity manager. Okay, this category, is responsible. So we can set that approval flow, like, you know, if you want to have a complete one category manager, I mean main, who will be responsible for all category. Apart from that, he'll have sub managers, like, you know, okay, he is responsible for IT department, he is commodity manager for IT department, he is commodity manager for construction or manufacturing. So we can have that.
Oh, that means when you create, that means you will create a workflow and attach the corresponding approval. Okay.
Yeah, approval flow. We can do that. So I just wanted to highlight this option, delegations. So this is one of the good options we have, like, you know, we can delegate our roles and responsibility for to another in case we are out of the organization for a few days. So using delegations, So yeah, delegation I was talking about. Delegation we can have some if any user is out of the organization for 1 month or 2 months. So we can delegate his roles and responsibility to approve any document to any other desired user. So he can be only able to approve the documents, right? He can't be able to create new task or new document on behalf of that user. So that is about delegations. I'll show you. This is coming here. This is supplier login. I don't know what happened to this site. This is supplier portal login. I am giving this buyer application URL, and it's coming supplier portal login. This is network. See, Kasi, you asked right where if I want to do business with them without into network. So they'll get this proposal, they'll procure POs and all will be sent to this network once they once they sign in, once they register. Otherwise, they won't get at all. I mean, they won't. What would be the communication channel? If it's offline, there is no need of Ariba at all. So that is the reason we should have suppliers to be registered in network. So yeah. So this is how we can do delegations, like I am a Ariba admin, I'm creating. So we have delegatee, we have a user who is affected. So to whom we need to delegate this? Delegator, let's take one example.
Rakesh, where is this delegation used for approving PR, or apart from that, is there any other place?
For approving any document, not only PR, event sourcing, event, any document in the sense invoice, PR, PO, award. So any document which needs an approval can be approved through using delegation. So delegator is the person who is out of the office for few days. Delegatee is the person to whom we are assigning that delegation. delegation start date, end date, reason of delegation, and save it. So you can plan it for future, like, okay, I know that from March 1 to April 1, I won't be in office, so all the to-do tasks offline will be assigned to that person. So this is how we can. So this is generally.
Rakesh, you are doing this as administrator, no? So me as a user, can I delegate somebody else on within my login ID? We cannot.
Yes, yes. So this is what I wanted to highlight. We will see administration role in coming. I mean, any requirement as any requirement comes, we are anyhow we are going and seeing administration roles and all, because it's a very huge. What all are required for functional consultant, I'll definitely tell you. As I said, from user, I created user group and all. So in coming session, every day we can have administration, some or the other, okay? Is that fine?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. Actually,
so, So I forgot to tell you one thing about event. In event, I showed you, right, Excel import and export while creating event, Excel import and export. So in that, while creating an event, you can import line items via offline also. Like I have 2000 line items for this event. We cannot keep on creating line item one by one. It's better I'll show you the exact example. I mean, how it is done. So you cannot keep on creating new one by one line item for 2000 line items. It will be very hard. So in that case, what we can do, we can directly export using Excel sheet to the system. How? I'll show you. It will take hardly 5 minutes, then we'll wind it up.
No, how are the line items in Excel?
Sorry?
Like, how did you get those line items in the Excel sheet?
I'll tell you. See, when we are creating event for 2000 line items, so we have that requirement in any of the other forms, like it might be in offline or it might be in some system or in. So we know that we have to create event for EC Ariba solution sourcing project. I have to add 2000 line items. So let me quickly create new project, right?
Okay. It's like in requirement gathering phase or analyzing phase or somewhere we got this item, this 2000 line item. Is it?
No. This is a requirement gathering, not requirement gathering phase or something. This is after implementation of the product in your premises or after implementing, when you create actual projects, customer, right?
Customer wants. Okay.
Yeah, customer. He is creating line item for 2000 line item. Okay. Then he can. I'll show you the other. So, Karthik, your another doubt was there, right? Regarding event selection of template.
Yeah.
See, I am selecting quick project here, right?
Yeah.
And I selected auction. See the list of auctions here, right? Auction, best template auction. Now I'll select. I'll select RFI or RFP. Now you can see. Just a minute.
Templates here, just to RFI.
Yeah, it will show pop-up templates related to RFP. Oh, the system is so slow today. So yeah, here you can see the template quick RFP. So it is it is purely on the event type we are selecting, right? Okay, now I have selected, already have some template in place. I'm selecting because I don't need to have any project explanation. I just wanted to show you how we export multiple line items to the system using Excel sheet.
Content.
Directly jumping into the content, I want to add. See, now it will ask for, you know, the available template. I mean, the template which is already there. It will ask for to download that template, and then upload the template after filling.
Okay, this should be the format.
Yeah, so we have to, what is that? Okay. Just a moment. So not only line item, we can, you know, we can also edit the auction rules and all using offline. As I said, we can do offline work and we can update it into system. See here, it will show you the complete event, not line items. It will show you complete event. Kasi, are you there? I think you're busy in call. Is it?
No. I'm here. Okay. I'm talking with the mute. Do you mind showing the navigation, please? Just one second. Show the navigation while it opens.
Which navigation?
The navigation. Yes. So when you go to content, and
I think the Excel sheet is opening now. The Excel symbol is showing here.
Okay.
So from here, so when you say directly Excel import, it is talking about complete event, right? You know,
okay.
Event. So as I said, we can even download the event template. I mean, even in Excel sheet, we can work on that. We can edit rules. We can add items. We can add suppliers. Again, we have to re-upload it. So, but this need to be, you know, more careful because each and every field must be according to the template, given information in the template. There should be data types applicable to the template. So we have to fill in careful. So once we fill that Excel sheet, we can import. So we have to click here. We have the option called import, browse. So we can import from that. I don't know why it's not opening.
Okay, that's fine.
So that's we can do. Possible, I'll show you some templates and how it looks like. I'm sorry. So anything else? So Karthik, you are saying, right, what could be the challenges for functional consultant? For me, the main challenge is, you know, I mean, what I feel is...
Basic challenge, right from basic challenges, like since I'm very new
basic challenge is like for any functional consultant, not only Ariba, when we go to client place for requirement gathering, we should pay attention, I mean, even 100% keen attention to that. Sometimes what happens, we feel like, okay, this is possible. I mean, it sounds like it is possible, but we should ask them 10 times, let them frustrate, let them get, you know, irritated. Sometimes what happens, customer also play a double game. I mean, like he'll ask in some other way and his requirement is different and he asks in some other way. Sometimes we are not confirmed, but we say, okay, it's possible, you know, to make customer keep calm. We just say, okay, it's possible. But what happens when you build a site, when that requirement is not, I mean, not coming into the configuration or site building, then the customer will file like anything. We literally, you know, Indian customers are more into that. If I'm paying the money, I want bloody everything. You know what? We committed for only 3, you know, training sessions to each of the key user, key training sessions like before UAT, after UAT, at the time of support, go live support. So, but you know how many times we give actually? 7 to 8 times we gave them a training. So this is what the challenges comes into. You should be...
Rakesh, sorry, just one final thing in the template. Where do you attach the workflow for the whole of the template? How do you control who is going to approve the event?
Approval flow.
Yes, for the whole of the workflow, the whole of the event. I mean, last time we discussed like it has to be attached to the template, so whoever is using it, that process of workflow will pick up.
I'm not sure do that. Not supporting, just a moment. Otherwise, we will do one thing, Kasi. We'll continue this in next. I'll definitely show you.
Sure.
I need some call and I have to move. I'll just make note of it and definitely show you. So it's not that big deal. I mean, just need to add in approval flow. I'll show you. Okay, we'll discuss because it will take at least 10 to 15 minutes. So I'll do that. Incoming session, is that okay?
Yeah,
that's fine, no problem.
Yeah, so we'll discuss that. I'll forward you those documents as well. I mean, few documents I have to share, I'll forward you. I mean, to Sai, he'll forward you. We can... So what is the next class, next session we can have, when we can have next session?
Now, can we have it Monday, please? Is it possible?
Yeah, Pratik, are you fine with Monday?
Yeah, Monday at what time?
Sorry, 8 o'clock or 7:30 something, somewhere around 8.
Will 7:30 do good for you guys? Okay, fine, I'm fine.
7 to 8.
7:45.
Yeah,
7:30.
Okay.
7:45. I think Kasi will be late in few minutes. That's okay. Otherwise we'll do one thing. We'll start by 7:30. Karthik, you can join by 7:45. Meanwhile, Kasi generally have some project related queries. So meanwhile we can discuss for 15 minutes. Is that okay, Kasi?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you so much, guys.
Yeah. Hello, have a nice day, Karthik. Good night. Okay. I know.
Thanks.
Day for you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good day.
Thank you. Bye.
No, you have also been on board. For extra, we have been to do. No problem, but certain, right? Everything.
Now, our top story, amidst the ongoing intense power struggle in the state of Tamil Nadu, the stage is set for the newly appointed Chief Minister E.K. Palanisamy to finally prove his majority on the floor of the House. And ahead of this big trust vote, Edappadi Palanisamy faction is quite confident of winning the trust vote as it claims to have 121 MLAs on their side. Meanwhile, the political slugfest has only intensified as the other loyalist of the late Chief Minister, Palanisamy, will be challenged by opening Selvam, who has a wafer in support of 12 MLAs. Just ahead of the crucial trust vote, OP has in fact made a desperate plea to all AIDNK MLAs by invoking Jayalalitha and saying, and urging rather, the MLAs not to support the newly sworn-in Chief Minister Edappadi Palanisamy in the trust vote. Meanwhile, interestingly, the DMK working president Stalin has said that the DMK would be also voting against Edappadi K. Palanisamy. But let's just take you through the numbers. This is what's most important. The actual strength of the Tamil Nadu Assembly is 234, which means if it's 234, the magic number, the simple majority would be 118. But now what has happened is, with the unfortunate demise of the late Chief Minister, the number has come down to 233. We're hearing that Karunanidhi is also unwell and he's unlikely to vote. Then the number comes down to 232. That includes the Speaker. But the Speaker votes only in case of a tie. So which means now the number is 231. That's the strength of the House. The number comes down to 231. Therefore, the magic number is 116, as you're seeing on that clock right now. Shashikala's camp, they claim they have the support of 121 MLAs, which is a comfortable number. If they do have those numbers, most of these MLAs have been staying at the Golden Bay Resort for days now. However, Openi Selvam's camp has only 12 MLAs. That's what they claim to have. Now, what's important here to note is that if the interim chief minister, Openi Selvam, gets the support of 6 more MLAs, that will add to his tally to 18, which means 12 plus 6, that is 18, and will bring down the numbers from 121 to 115 of the VK Sasikala camp. Their numbers would reduce to 115. That is one less from the magic number. Why are they saying one less? Remember, it was 100 of these MLAs have been saying the two. That includes the Speaker. But the Speaker votes only in case of a tie. So which means now the number is 231. That's the strength of the House. The number comes down to 231, therefore the magic number is 116, as you're seeing on that graph right now. Shashikala's camp, they claim they have the support of 121 MLAs, which is a comfortable number if they do have those numbers. Most of these MLAs have been staying at the Golden Bay Resort for days now. However, Openi Selvam's camp has only 12 MLAs. That's what they claim to have. Now, what's important here to note is that if the interim chief minister, OpenESLVM, gets the support of 6 more MLAs, that will add to his tally to 18, which means 12 plus 6, that is 18, and will bring down the numbers from 121 to 115 of the VK Sasikala camp. Their numbers would reduce to 115. That is one less from the magic number. Why are we saying one less? Remember, it was 115, the magic number in the 231 assembly. One less is because just yesterday, one of the MLA, Mr. Nasraj, said that he will be voting against the newly inducted, the newly sworn in chief minister, Idappadi K. Palaniswamy. Now, ahead of the big floor test today, let's just take you through the various strategy. What would be the strategies of these two warring factions who have been, you know, locked in this very bitter turf war? The OPS plan would be in his favor when that crucial protest takes place at about 10 in the morning. That really is going to be something that both these leaders will be looking out for. The plan is to ensure that, you know, every effort is taken that the EPS camp or the VK Sasikala camp loses in the protest. But Idappadi K. Palaniswamy would be heavily reliant. Sensational revelation by Subramanian Swami of the BJP to India Today. He has said that as far as I know, the Union government has no role to play in the governance stand. But what I heard that there can be a certain Union minister who are taking undue interest in what is happening in Tamil Nadu. I cannot name them. I want that.